to Nauticus on another one of these virtual adventures. Today I'm standing in front of our eel tank, and we just have the one animal in this tank right here. This is a green moray eel, and he's actually still not fully grown, even though he is quite large. You can see him behind me in this tank. He's one of my favorite animals here at Nauticus. He's got such a personality. He's wonderful. So the first thing that I always like sharing about green moray eels is that their skin color is not green. They're actually brown. They excrete a yellow mucus all over the outside of their skin to be able to protect themselves from parasites. And he really does look green, so it's very effective for him. In addition, our moray eel here also has this really cool adaptation. He has two sets of jaws. So you can see externally, he has his external jaw, just like we have, you know, with our mouth, and he can open that and hold that open as he's waiting for prey to pass by, you know, as he's hunting and kind of looking around. But our moray eel actually has a second set of jaws called a pharyngeal jaw, and it's back in his throat, essentially. So he has his external jaw out here, and then his pharyngeal jaw is back in his throat. And that's why when he hunts, he's going to just have his mouth open, wait for prey to pass by, and that way his pharyngeal jaw is actually what's going to come forward and kind of clamp onto stuff to catch it and pull it back into his throat so that he can eat. So he has these two sets of jaw. If you've ever seen the movie Alien, where the alien opens its mouth and it has that second mouth inside, your pharyngeal jaws are actually an inspiration for that. So as horrifying as that is actually true. That is similar to what they look like. So he has his pharyngeal jaw, and then a fun little thing that these guys can do, they actually can, their body is flexible enough that they can tie themselves up into a knot. They are actually able to do that. We don't see our guy doing that very often. He's often just swimming through and exploring his tank. He is actually this thing called pump trained, which means that when the pump turns off, he knows that he can come up and he'll come up to the top of the tank and accept food from his carer, an aquarist who works here at Nauticus. And she doesn't hand it to him with her bare hand. She's going to use a nice claw hand to reach out for him to accept it. But he is actually trained. He's very intelligent. He knows that that's when he's going to get food. He'll come up to the top of the tank to get that. Unfortunately for a poor aquarist, she does have to turn the tank off, turn off the pump when she comes to clean the tank. So sometimes when she's coming over, not to feed him, but just to clean, she'll turn off the pump and he'll race up for food. And there's none for him to have. And so he'll kind of put on his dramatics and go over to a corner and kind of sulk for a little bit that he didn't get his food like he was expecting. So I'm sure everyone's experienced this if they have cats or dogs at home that have sulked when they didn't get what they wanted. But our eel does that too. So we're really happy to have him now back in his rock face over here. Thank you for coming on another one of these virtual adventures at Nauticus. We look forward to having you once we reopen our doors.